Hi students, are you listening to the class daily? Yes, listen carefully everyone. If you have doubts, put pause the video and rather do your write your home good work also if you need means. Okay, then you have to listen carefully. Did you complete the last homework, last class, previous class homework? Okay, complete your homework also in time. Okay. And what we discuss our previous class, what is the name of the topic? Yes, we discussed about life cycle. Life cycle, is it right? Okay. So in every animal lifespan, they have life cycle. Okay. So in this life cycle, different stages are there. So when they cross the different stages, finally they will give birth to animals, after that they will die. Okay. So in this life cycle we discussed about life cycle of butterfly. First of all, by life cycle of a seed. Seed, when we sow seed, it grows like a small plant, that is called seedling. Okay, when the seedling get leaves, with the help of leaves, it starts making food. After that, it is growing slowly in big size, okay, and that will happen, slowly flowers also growing in the plants. So when the flowers pollinated with the help of some worms, what are they? Honeybees, butterflies, wind, water, these are the agents of pollination. So when they get, when the pollination is, a male flower is producing pollen grains. So when these pollen grains transfer from male flower to female flower, that is called the pollination. Is it right? So in this pollination, what will happen? They get these flowers change like a fruits. Okay. After that, what will happen? From the fruits, we are getting seeds. We are getting seeds. Again, from the seeds, we are getting new plants. So this is a one cycle. It is happening. Okay. So that is called, we are seeing this type of life cycle in the plant. In the same way, we discussed in the life cycle in butterfly. So it has also, first of all, adult butterfly legs. After that, these eggs, after hatching, small larvas coming. So these are larvae. This is called caterpillar. So it is a eating stage, it is moving stage. After that, they get rest. So when they are in resting stage, that is called the pupa stage. When the pupa developed, it is coming like an adult butterfly. It changed like an adult butterfly. This is the life cycle in the butterfly. This one we discussed in the previous class. Is it right? Now we are going to discuss another topic. So what is that? Egg. What is that? Egg. Okay. We know that egg is present around us. Air is present around us. You see, generally in our homes or in our classroom, fan is rotating, okay, over our head. Okay, so something feeling, happy feeling, or one type of feeling is getting. Is it that? But can we see the air? Can we see the air with our eyes? No, we can't see. But how we know that? Just feeling. When fan is rotating, it is that air is coming, producing. So that air is heating to our skin, then we feel cool feeling. Suppose if you switch off the fan, how is the room? Very hot is there. We are getting suffocating. We feel suffocating. That's why then we are on the switch on the fan. When it is on, fan is rotating, automatically air is producing. And when the air is producing from the fan, and it is heating our skin, then we are getting cool air. So like that we are getting feel only, but we can't see with our eyes. Okay, why we are not seeing air with our eyes means air has no taste. First of all, air has no taste. If we taste the water, if we taste the air, it has no air, no taste, and it has no color or odor. And it has no taste, color, okay, and odor, no smell. Odor means smell. This is called odor. Odor means smell. So air has no taste, air has no color, air has no smell. Nothing is there. That is why we are not seeing with our eyes. Is it clear? And in the same way, if you see, one is when fan is rotating, that air hits our skin, then we feel air is coming, air is there. And then sometimes if you see outside, branches of the trees, branches of this, they are swinging like this. That one also tells us air is blowing. Okay, now, air is blowing. That is called, we are saying that blowing air is called wind. Okay, yes. And in the same way, air is important. Air is an important thing. Okay, how it is important? We see, we can breathe. We can breathe air. Air means inside the air, what is there? Oxygen is there. What is there? Oxygen. So our body need oxygen. So from where we are getting this oxygen? From the air. Is it clear? And in the same way, it is useful to environment also. So many living things are there. So these all things need oxygen. How we are getting this oxygen? From the air. Is it clear? And in the same way, plants need carbon dioxide. Plants need carbon dioxide. That is called CO2. CO2 means carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide. Short name, chemical name is CO2, carbon dioxide. So this carbon dioxide also available part in the air only. This carbon dioxide is very useful for plants. How it is useful for plants? Plants are preparing food, already we know that. So in that time, plants are taking carbon dioxide from the air. So with the help of carbon dioxide, they are preparing food. Okay, clear? That's why they need carbon dioxide. In the same way, nitrogen gas is there. So nitrogen helps to plants. Nitrogen also helps to plants to make fertile. For healthy growing purpose, this nitrogen help to the plant as a fertile. Okay, so these are all gases. What are they? Oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen. So these are all available. These are all mixing in the air. Okay? Yes. Next, let us discuss composition of air. Are you understanding? Yes. Now we are going to discuss composition of air. Composition of air. Composition means combination. Okay. So air is that we are discussing here about air. Is it clear? But how this air is formed? What type of combinations are there? If you see in the air, it is a mixer of gases. It is a mixer of gases. Air is a mixer of gases. Mixings are there in the air. So what type of gases mixings, gas mixings are there in the air? If you see in this, in the air we are observing nitrogen. What is that? Nitrogen and oxygen, carbon dioxide, okay, and other thing, water vapor also is there. What is that? Water vapor and dust particles. Dust particles. Okay, already we discussed what type of combinations are there in the air. Means it is a mixture of gases. So what are the gases here? Nitrogen is one of the gases. Oxygen is there. Carbon dioxide is there. And water vapor, dust particles. So here totally how many are there? 1, 2, 3, water vapor 4, and dust particles 5. Totally 5 items are there. These are all formed together A. These are all formed A. So this is composition of A. But in them, if you see, nitrogen is there. Nitrogen is there, oxygen is there, carbon dioxide is there, water vapor, dust particles are there. So if you think them like 100% means, these are all 100% are there. So when they are mixing like 100%, okay, when they are in 100% position, then we are getting here A. So in this 100%, nitrogen is there. So nitrogen percentage is in 100%, 78% of nitrogen is there. How much percentage is there? 78% of nitrogen is there in 100%. Clear? Next. And oxygen is there. Oxygen is 21% is there. 21% oxygen is there. And remaining how much is there? 78% nitrogen, okay, 21% oxygen. Total how much is there? 8 1 plus 9 7 plus 2 9. So 99% of nitrogen and oxygen only is there in the air. Totally 78 plus 21 99% nitrogen, oxygen only occupied. And the remaining how much percentage is there in 100%? Remaining 1% is there. So this 1%, what is there? This 1% is carbon dioxide, water vapor, and dust particles. Dust particles. So in this 1%, okay, now 78% nitrogen is there, 21% oxygen is there. Remaining one percent, in this 1%, carbon dioxide is there, water vapor is there, and dust particles also are there. These three things are in how much percentage is there? 1% is there. So totally how much is there here? 1% is there. Total 100%. So this is the composition of air. Composition of air. Understood everyone? Yes. See once. What is the composition? What type of gases are there in the air? So it is a mixture of gases. So in this gases. In this mixture of gases, what type of gases are there? Nitrogen is there, oxygen is there, carbon dioxide is there, water vapor is there, and dust particles are there. So these are the five mixers. So in them, nitrogen 78% is there, oxygen 21% is there, remaining 1% carbon dioxide, water vapor, and dust particles are there. So when they form like this, when they form all together, and finally we are getting here air. Okay, clear? Understood everyone? Yes. Now this is about composition of air. Now we are going to discuss small topic, that is uses of air. Uses of air. Okay. Do you know what are the uses of air? Yes, let's see here. One of the uses of air is used for breathing. This is the first thing. Air is used for breathing. Air is used for breathing. Already you know, we are all breathing. Not only we, all living beings, whatever it, they need oxygen. Is it that? That's why they are all breathing. So air is used for breathing. Already we discussed, already we know about that. We are all breathing. So how we are breathing air? So with the help of nose, windpipe, and lungs, especially lungs. So already we see here in our chest region, lungs are there. So these lungs are working with the help of a diaphragm. Okay, that diaphragm is the muscle part. When it is pulled down the lungs downside, our lungs will expand like this. Then automatically air enters into our lungs. When the diaphragm push up, then what will happen? They will get compressed. So then what will happen? Our lungs will get a contract. Then automatically air comes out. And this is called inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. This inhale and exhale is called breathing. These are the two involves. This is called breathing. Okay, these two things are involving in the breathing. That is inhale and another one is exhale. Then what will happen? Air enters into our lungs and away comes out. In this process, in this breathing process, or in this inhaling and exhaling process, what will happen when we take air inside? So in the air, what is there? Oxygen. So our body needs oxygen. So in our lungs, what will happen when the air enters into the, are filled in the lungs? In the lungs, what will happen? Carbon dioxide is forming in our body. That carbon dioxide enters into the lungs. So in the lungs already oxygen is there. No? This oxygen mixing in the blood. So in gases, these two gases are exchanging in our lungs. This is called breathing. So air is used for breathing. That is the reason. Clear? Next, this is one use. And another use, air is used for photosynthesis. Air is used for photosynthesis. Already you know, in the process of photosynthesis, plants are preparing food. Plants are preparing food. Is it right? Already we know about photosynthesis process. What is happening in the photosynthesis process? Plants are taking sunlight from the sun. Already we know. So this sunlight observed by the chlorophyll. By the chlorophyll, this is the green color substance in the leaves. So with the help of this chlorophyll, okay, this chlorophyll traps the sunlight. This chlorophyll traps the sunlight, and leaves have stomata under the leaves have stomata under the part of leaf. Okay, so this with the help of the stomata, they take carbon dioxide. They take a carbon dioxide, and with the help of roots, they are taking or observing water and minerals. Water and minerals. Okay, so they are taking in the photosynthesis process. What will happen? With the help of chlorophyll, they trap sunlight. With the help of stomata, they take carbon dioxide gas from the air, and with the help of root system, they absorb water and minerals. With the help of these products, what are they? Sunlight, carbon dioxide, water and minerals. With the help of these things, plants are preparing their food. Plants are preparing their food. This process is called photosynthesis. So in the photosynthesis, how is the air useful? Means carbon dioxide is one of the part in the air. So this, how this carbon dioxide they are observing from the air? If there is no carbon dioxide in the air, will they prepare their own food? Plants, they don't prepare their own food. That is why air is used for photosynthesis. Is it clear? Yes. Next one is air is needed for burning. Air is needed for burning. Already we know that one. For burning purpose, here we need air. Is it there? Okay. How it is possible? See, if you take one candle, okay, put that one on the bench or table, lift that one, and you have to take one glass and invert the glass on the candle. Clear? Then what will happen? Sometime it will burn. Are you understanding? Take one candle, lift that one, it is glowing, and around above the candle you have to lift one, invert the glass like this. Sometime it will burn, after that it will put off, means it is not burning still. What is the reason? Inside the inverted glass, air is there. Empty is the glass, yes, in that empty space that is filled with air. In that air, some percentage of oxygen is there. So how much percentage of oxygen is there inside the glass, that much time it will burn. After that, slowly what will happen, it is the lightning candle is absorbing oxygen. So after that, when it is consuming, after that it will complete, it will over oxygen percentage. So that is total filled with carbon dioxide gas. Smoke is releasing, no? In the smoke, what is there? Lot of carbon dioxide is there. So this total glass filled with carbon dioxide, then automatically it will put off. So here, what we are discussing here, air is needed for burning. Means in the air, oxygen is there. Oxygen is helping. Oxygen is giving help to burn things, whatever. So that is why air is needed for burning. With this experiment, we know about it. Just 1 or 2 minutes it will burn candle, after that it will put off. What is the reason? Inside air is there. Inside air, but which one is more percentage is there? Carbon dioxide is there. First of all, when we invert here, all equal percentage is there. According to the number wise, nitrogen percentage, oxygen percentage, carbon dioxide percentage is there. But when it is burning inside the inverted glass, slowly oxygen is consuming, carbon dioxide is increasing. Then it will put off immediately after 2-3 minutes later. Clear? So that is why air is needed for burning. This is another use. And another one is, air is used to produce energy. So with the help of air, we are producing energy also. Energy means electricity. Do you know windmill? Yes. So windmills are windmills they have fans, big fans. Windmills fans are rotating with the help of wind. That's why they are rotating like this. This fan is connected to the motor. From the motor, electricity is generating or producing. That is why air is used for to produce energy. Okay. And in the same way, inflate objects. Inflate objects means suppose cycle tires, car tires, tubes are there. They have tubes. So without air in the car tire or in the bicycle tire, can we drive, can we move them? No, it's not possible. So inflate means we are when we fill the air inside the tube, it will get inflate. Means changing into bigger size. So that is inflating. So we are filling air inside the cycle tubes, car tubes, or balls, basketballs, volleyballs, then only they will work. Otherwise, they don't work. So we are using air like this also. And in the same way, air is used in adventure sports. Adventure sports. Some sports are there. So these sports are working with the help of air only. Example, parachute is there. Hot air balloon. Next, surfing. Surfing is the help of waves, no limit. And parasailing, paragliding, and kite flying. Paragliding. These are all sports. Paragliding. Sports in the same way we are using them. To move from one place to another place, we are using parachutes, hard air balloons, like that. Okay, so these are all games, and we are using for moving from one place to another place. Okay, so like this purpose also we are using air. Okay, these are the uses of air. Understood everyone? Yes. And after completing this topic, first of all you have to listen the class, this video, and after that you have to write the homework as usual. Now I am going to give homework on this topic. Okay, what is the homework? Write the composition of air. What are the uses of air? Dash. Helps in burning and breathing, burning and breathing. The ash helps the plants in making food. Making food. This is homework or assignment for you. After listening the class, you have to complete this homework in time. Okay, write the composition of air. What are the use of air? Dash helps in burning and breathing. Dash helps the plant in making food. Is it clear? Understood? Do you understood? Yes. Thank you all.